Okay, guys, it is about 6-something in the morning. We're gonna go get in the blind for the first hunt of the trip.
We just got out of the truck, alright? Me and Evan just drove down here. This is so cool because I've known this has been a thing, but I've never seen it. So there's been a lot of rain. So the hog wallow right here is being used like crazy. Look at that. All the pigs during the day rolling in it. And
Getting inside a hawk almost got in the blind with him. Welcome back to Low Standard Lighting. So right now we just got set up a cadence of a hawk. That's what that little phone conversation was in Charles's wrist. Basically, now we're just set up in the old blind waiting for some hogs to come in. It's currently about 6:30 or so in the morning. We probably went to bed about 3 hours ago. Woke up feeling good. It's just another beautiful day out here in paradise. Gonna hopefully get a few hogs and then get our work started for the day. Build a little fence, cut down some trees, paint a blind. That's what we're gonna do first. Not this blind, but the other two blinds. And right now we're just waiting for some hogs. So I'm gonna turn off this flashlight so I don't scare off any things that come around here.
That's a big ass boar.
Should we wait for the boar to come in or what? Not with the boar. We just gotta take him out.
Should we both go at it? Do you want to?
Here, I think we both need to go at it. I think that's just more.
Well, that's how we do it.
Well, that took all of 15 minutes.
I don't want to finish our hunt yet.
Okay, let's go drag him out.
Yeah, let's go move this sucker and set back up, I guess. Let's do it again.
Adrenaline.
A little bit of adrenaline? Just a little bit. Yeah, that happened. Okay, so guys, basically what y'all saw is as we were, I think we had just got the camera set up. And what Charles did was he set up this little camera tripod right here. I don't know if y'all can really see it, but it's like a little for your iPhone. And so he was using that to kind of film us that one angle that you saw, not the angle pointing at the feeder. Right as he got that set up, we looked down there and a boar had walked out. That boar right there. It's a nice sized boar. So we were basically like, because I brought my gun this time, because what our plan was is if we had multiple, we would, you know, both pick our boar, just say, you know, 3, 2, 1, shoot, and then go at it like that. But only one walked out, so we didn't want to, you know, wait for another one to walk out. So I was just like, you know what, Charles, go ahead. Since he already had his gun set up, I didn't feel like, you know, taking the time to get my gun all set up and then potentially losing this hog. So we've literally not been here for more than 20 minutes, so I think what we're gonna do is just drag him off somewhere to the side, a place where he won't be really a distraction or a deterrent for other hogs, and then reset all this stuff and try to get another one, maybe another boar or free sows or just whatever will show up, because, you know, really, this has been awesome, but I don't know what he's saying. But I think, you know, we still have time, so I think we could still get a few more. I really can't tell how big this thing is from this angle, but it looks like a pretty good size. All right, Charles. Oh, all right.
Oh my goodness, yes. Yes. Look at this. Yeah, turkey.
Blind? Go get up close and personal look at this big old boar. Holy shoot, this is a massive pig. Just walking out of the blind, decided to finish our hunt. It's about like 8:30 or so. Getting a little up close and personal look at this boar. God dang, bro. Just want you to take a look at the size of this hog. It compared to my boot.
Man, that is a big old boar.
Alright guys, take a look at this. These cutters on this one. Man. That's where he stuck him. Right there in the head. That hole. That is a bullet hole.
I mean, this is the area we hunt in, and we're trying to keep it nice, and that's what pigs do right there. One bay here, look at all that back there. Torn up like crazy here. And all this right here, these roots. Picked up, pulled out down there. Cactus gotten in too. More right on top of here. And we got this whole area here. I mean, this is just in this small little area. And you know, you think about what happens to entire pieces of property. Even people that have like crops and stuff, like, just there's so much.
So that, guys, is why we shoot pigs. Those of you that, I don't know, maybe don't hunt and you see us shoot this boar, you're like, why are you shooting that? You're not probably not going to eat it. You're like, well, that's why you shoot it, because it ruins the land. And it ruins just the environment. You gotta take care of the environment so that the things that you actually do wanna eat and you wanna shoot for food will, you know, have a nice place to live and wanna keep coming back. Also, these pigs don't just live here. They'll go to other properties. You know, places like Charles was saying with crops, farmers, that's not good for that. So you wanna get rid of them, you know? They'll destroy that land, and then where are you gonna get your, I don't know, vegetables and stuff? Also, the little ones, the little sows, are tasty. Not this one though. I don't know if you wanna eat this one. So, we're gonna get some pictures. All right, next step in the process, getting this thing loaded into the truck. It's doable.
Dude, I hate bugs.
Yeah, the bugs out here suck. The bugs weren't that bad last time, but god dang, they suck today. Get this thing loaded into the truck. Not gonna be impossible. Definitely gonna be a lot more difficult than the last one that we did. Conclusion.
concludes this hunt. Not the video, but I think we're gonna go pick up Caden. I don't know if he's done or what he's doing. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Okay, so we have like 400 pounds of, or no, that's a little bit of an exaggeration. Maybe like 200 pounds of animal in the back of the truck. We're gonna go pick up Caden, then go dump this thing somewhere. I don't think Caden's seen anything besides a hawk. What's up, guys? We dumped that pig off yonder that a ways, sitting there dying. Or, well, it is dead, but it's sitting there getting eaten by things. And so right now, what we're doing is we're gonna go get some barbed wire, and we're going to go to some old abandoned house that probably has snakes. Caden's gonna do some crazy crackhead. What are you doing?
You kick it.
Why?
Because it turns your boot black.
My boots are already kind of black.
No, it turns them like black.
All right. Kick it. Whoa! I wonder if that's how you make black dye in real life. Like in Minecraft, you know how it's,
and then look,
it's squids?
More right here. These are like,
I wonder if that's how you do it. Basically, this old abandoned house,
old abandoned house
has an old abandoned barbed wire in it. We need to go get it so we can make a fence.
That's sponsorship.
Sponsored by Venom.
Ah!
Look at these trees, bro. These trees are awesome.
Awesome trees.
If you look to your right, you will see an old abandoned diesel tank. This is what we use to, oh, that bird scared me. We get diesel from here and then put it on trees so that we can burn down in a safe, controlled environment though. Oh my gosh, a freaking dragon almost attacked us. Okay, if you hear that humming sound, that is the sound of 1,000 bees. Because this house is actually like kind of surrounded by a bunch of beehives. So we're making Caden go in there.
Is that where we went in last time?
In the name of science.
Y'all gotta go in there because I'm gonna hand it out to you because there's multiple tails.
Holy Jesus Christ, dude.
Yeah. There's a whole nest and a half in there.
Giant bee's nest right there.
I gotta poop.
You gotta poop?
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for telling everyone.
That's where we went last time.
I would go through that one.
Which one?
The one right there.
Okay, so how are we gonna get this barbed wire out of here?
Someone's gotta go with me so I can hand it off to you.
All right, guys, since y'all insist, I'm gonna go in there with Caden. In the name of...
I'm walking as far away from that as possible.
Charles, go get some footage of that
beehive. Yeah, some B-roll.
Some B-roll, get
it?
Literally.
It's B-roll.
Man. Oh, give me your...
What if
your,
I just... What if I...
Block. Just in case. Just in case the bees
come after
us. Start some
basically
yeah. I'm gonna get some distance.
You're the cameraman, bro. You don't get distance. You gotta get up close and personal.
How do you think they film those lion shows?
How do you think they film the lion shows? You think you think Lion King was filmed by someone keeping their distance?
No.
No. No, it wasn't.
Evan, shut up and get through the hole.
That's what she said.
They're following me!
Oh my gosh.
Evan, I'm gonna go get a GoPro.
Why?
And maybe I'll be past that.
Oh my goodness. Okay, we got some barbed wire. Not even close to all of it. There's like probably about like four more of these back there. And then like some other small rolls, but got the trusty 31 round clip Glock. I can probably shoot about 31 bees with this, because I'm pretty much just dead accurate with bee shooting. Caden's coming out. Caden, how many are left?
I don't know.
They sting you? Run!
Charles, don't go over there. Oh, I got stung by like three of them. Ow! I don't think you're supposed to do that.
What?
Whenever bees are chasing you. Ow. Oh god, I'm not going back there.
Okay.
I'm not doing this. I got stung like eight times in my head. What am I supposed to
What if I
gave me a Glock to I got stung like nine times trying to get barbed wire for your dog feeder. Oh my god. Ben, don't bring him over here. That's why I didn't see me right there, that crowbone.
What?
Bees happened.
Did y'all not get the camera?
No!
Did you get stung?
Yes! Once on my face and like four times on
Why did y'all get the camera?
You go get the camera! The bees aren't mad at you!
Well, let's see how this goes. I just gotta go get back there and get the camera and my drink. Oh man, I can hear them buzzing. The target has been spotted. There's the camera. All right, here's my drink. A bee's in the drink. Okay. The drink is clear. It's like just 30 feet, nothing. I feel like Sandlot right now, you know, about to pickle the beast, you know? Let's get it.
Grab the camera, back out.
Run, run, run. Back, back. Okay. All right. Where's the camera?
You still rolling? We're good.
Dude, there wasn't even any bees over there. I didn't see a single one, Evan.
Are you recording anything?
I was recording all of it.
On this?
Yeah.
You were only recording for 27 seconds.
I know, because I just started another video when I walked up here.
I hate you, Charles, because you didn't get stung.
I'm never going outside again. I think that might be one right there. I can't even tell, really. So there's, yeah, right there. Right there, definitely I got stung. And then the top of my head has like 20... No, not like 20, but there's like two or three on top of my head. Caden got stung on top of his head like twice. We're not talking to Charles anymore because he just walked down there like he loved it and just like didn't even get stung at all.
Wait.
Wow, me and Caden almost died trying to get stupid barbed wire. The thing that sucks though is we're going to have to go back later today to get him. Because we have to do it, or else we just came here for nothing, and we can't let some bees scare us off. I don't know why I said, oh yeah, I'll follow you in there. I just thought it was going to be fun. I was like, yeah, I'll go with you.
I thought the bees were just kind of staying at there.
I thought they were just... The thing is, I wasn't doing anything to like piss them off. I was just standing there. And they were like,
pointed
no.
The gun at them.
I didn't point the gun at them.
At the bees.
You showed up to their doorstep with a gun.
I did not point my gun at them.
Because I'm pretty much just dead accurate with bee shooting.
That much.
What?
But anyways, that's what happened. We got stung by a bunch of bees and it sucked. I guess me and Caden did. Charles didn't. Charles isn't part of the bee sting club. Not cool.
I did it before, it was cool.
Bee gang.
Yeah, you only got stung.
Bee
like,
gang.
On the nose.
That's what you call bee roll.
And here are some don'ts. One, don't swat at a bee. So don't leave any open soda cans, popsicle sticks, or ripe fruit lying around outside.
I left a drink over here.
Sponsored by Venom.
Everybody, welcome back. We are going to go paint a deer blind.
It's like a little 12-inch 2x4.
Did you get there?
This up here?
Yeah.
Oh, possibly.
I think Dad thinks we're just painting the outside. We painted the entire inside. There's some spots, but you know, there's a roof. So like, it'll be okay, I think.
This will go alright.
It'll go alright.
I have paint in my hair.
It's
like a broom.
Detail check.
That hurts.
Drop zone alpha.
Drop
bravo. Rendezvous Charlie.
What's up, everyone? Just painted a blind. Something I've never done before. So many freaking bugs out here. So now we're heading to the old blind, back blind, whatever. I don't know what that was.
Camera one checking in.
Hey, where's that lid?
Operation get the barbed wire. We're gonna do something really not smart. Remember all that stuff earlier? With the bees? Well, we're all suited up. We're going back. We need the barbed wire. You got PTSD, Evan? You ready to do it? You ready to go?
PTSB.
Why are there so many bee puns?
Keep going. You're good. Go.
Oh, look, there's a rabbit.
Look. Yeah.
I got it.
That's what Evan had.
All right, guys, we're done. Let's go home. Okay, come on, Evan. Da 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 doo 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 doo. Ow, freaking A. Everything's spiky.
Hey, Carl, if there's a bug, don't swat it.
Shut up. Okay. All right, where are we going?
To get the barbed
wire. Okay. Okay, we're here.
Oh. I have one glove.
Oh, well then here, take the machete. I'll grab that.
I can get it.
This is like...
Yeah, out of here.
I don't even see any more than this. Yep, put it on the beehive, make them think it's daytime. You think that's all? That's like worth a crap down there?
Basically, I don't know. I think we should just go look again.
Okay.
Basically, there's another hive right there.
Right up there.
Right over there. We haven't had to deal with this one yet.
The gate we're getting out is right there. Caden's taking the lead.
Caden, I don't know what I'm doing though.
Walk into that gap and around. Let's go. Lead up.
What?
We're coming behind you.
Wait, no, okay, hold on. What am I cutting, first of all?
You don't really need to cut anything. Grab the gate, see if it comes out.
I hate that noise of bees, dude.
That's so productive. Hopefully that's not a bee hole right there.
Wait, right there? That is.
Chills, you're going to have to help me pull it out of here.
Okay.
Like, kind of just...
Oh, shoot, is that a bee? Caden, bee! Bee! Bee!
Are you serious?
No. No, no. Come on! Okay, come on. Oh, shoot.
Are you okay?
No, I died.
Come on, Evan.
Okay. Look at that. Oh, okay. Lay it down. Like right there. You want to slide a couple of these barbed wire things off?
No.
No?
Nope.
You want to do them tomorrow?
Oh, no, that's a good idea. Yeah, maybe we should.
You should have grabbed another glove from Caden. Feels so like cool whenever I put the chest strap on, bro. Get out of the road, Carol! Come on, sweetheart!
Recovering the bees, done.
It's out with the old, in with the new. Goodbye, clouds of gray. Hello, skies of blue. A dip in the paint. Paint the brush. And days in my shades, we're losing our minds.
What are you talking about?
Make sure y'all hit us up, lowstandardpaints.gov. We'll get all your painting needs.
Just beat the devil, just like this. Just beat the devil out of it.
Yeah, this ladder is at a very nice angle. Look, look. You see, look. You see that? That's what we're working with here.
Hey, you need sauce.
Michael,
you
here.
You can do it.
Beat the devil out of that paintbrush.
I want you to, Charles, show him that paintbrush. That thing has been through some stuff.
Painting, 2 days painting blinds, like.
2 days painting blinds with us. I think any experienced person would have like been able to take better care of this, but we just...
Caden is playing wheel and stick game.
As in the early 1400s.
Made popular by the movie A Christmas Carol.
He's really bad at it.
Not sure if he's winning or losing.
He's losing because he's not using a stick.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can play it either way, but usually the stick is the more traditional rules. That's the way I grew up playing it. But,
yeah.
But I mean, you can play it different ways. You can play it with your hand, but if you're playing with a barbed wire spool, it's usually not a good idea.
Yeah.
So I suggest using a stick.
Yeah, but like back in our day, I mean.
Back when you were a little younger. Yeah, back when you were younger.
Do a circle.
It's barbed wire.
Do a circle. I can't see anything, Evan. We took it out of the cold house. Basically, all three of us are going to one blind.
We painted this today, and I like it. It feels a lot smaller, but it's obviously not because we shoved three people in here. We built a barbed wire
fence with a protein feeder. That should attract.
You need a protein feeder.
It should attract pigs and deer.
You have to keep the cows away. So you make a fence around it to keep the cows away.
How about we turn it around at the thing? Yeah, there it is.
All right, let's actually be quiet now.
No, that's not how you hunt. Go.
You ready, Caden?
No. Voice of 11. You ready, Caden?
No.
Alright, no point in Caden.
Say, I got the one on the left.
Alright.
Wait, why would he get the one on the left? That means I shoot the one on the right or cross bullets.
Say you get the one on the right.
Alright, ready, go?
Go.
I got the one on the right.
But I want to shoot the one on the right.
No, I want to shoot the one on the right.
Shut the fuck up.
Charles is really trying his best. He's really putting his heart and soul into it. So I think he's doing his best. So
I don't give consent for you filming me.
But right, but like to the right, like all right on the right outside of the black in the middle.
Like perfect up and down, but.
Did you hit one right there? God damn it!
Welcome back to another episode of Charles finds a random microphone in Evan's camera bag. Today we're going to do ASMR really close to the microphone as Evan puts the gun up onto the fire pit. He takes off the safety because he's ready to shoot. Right now he's aligning his shot and reaching for the trigger. As we can see here, he has to readjust because he probably sucks at shooting. It's starting to rain. He's putting his finger to the trigger, releasing the safety as he slowly squeezes into the trigger. The bullet fires and the recoil is extreme.
Did he get away, Evan? Evan, just put your head in there. Just put your head in there.
Y'all remember when we went swimming? Remember when we went fishing in that river? We'll show y'all what we're talking about. This was killed like right there, like not even that long ago.
Yeah!
Faster, Evan.
Chase him into the house.
Oh yeah, Evan!
My butt's gonna drag so hard. Get your legs out.
Look at the chicken.
Large talons, so let's look at them.
Look at the talons.
Wow, those are large.
Look, does he have a nice face?
take the camera.
Is that
the white one right there?
There's a little secret to them.
Is that the white one?
Each one of the chickens, there's a little secret to them.
What?
The black chickens grow up to be the biggest chicken. The red ones try to be the meanest. The white ones actually weigh about 3 eggs a day and about...
3 eggs a day?
So those are the ones you
want. That's awesome. That's really cool, actually. 3 eggs a day? So if you wanted to, you could just have eggs every day for breakfast from the same chicken.
Hello, everybody. My name is Evan Bratton. I'm a wildlife expert. Today, I have my friend Hayden Croft lock me inside a chicken coop. I'm going to attempt to catch a chicken.
Go get
Let me out.
Go get a chicken.
I don't want a chicken.
The big bun.
I caught a chicken. I cornered him in there because I knew that I was smarter than him because I am the more evolved creature. But he's actually really cute and I like him. All right, buddy.
Okay, guys, I'm Evan Bratton. Today, we're going to be hypnotizing a chicken. So first, what you got to do is you push him. You put him on the ground like this. Then you make sure he sits down and you push his head into
the... Evan, he's not squatting.
Sit, squat him... down. Get down. Get down. Sit down.
Sit down.
I don't think he's going to force his head.
Sit down. And then you push his head
and
into the ground like this.
Draw a line on
him. And then you just
draw a line.
Like
a straight line, Evan.
A straight line like this. And then you push your head into it.
And then draw the line.
He's hypnotized. He's not going to move now. Okay, wait,
so keep his head there. Straight line from its beak.
Oh my goodness.
It worked. All
right, guys, in case you ever wanted to know how to
he did it like
properly slaughter a chicken without them running away.
And
that's how you do it.